أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم and welcome everyone who has entered the class on time. Anyone who is still not signing in with the correct ID, could you please log out and then log in again? You will be put into the waiting room, so do please log out and then enter with the with your assigned IDs. Also a reminder that make sure that your videos are off. Again, if they are on, then you will be put into the waiting room. A quick reminder of etiquette of the classroom, that TOEFLs should have their heads covered with a topi, and that NASAL should also have their heads covered with a scarf. And I hope that before entering this class, all of you have done your wuzu, inshallah. And with that, we will start our class. So for that, let's choose a student. Can I have a 1115, please? Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam.
How are you?
I'm
good, alhamdulillah. Do you want to help me with the starting prayer over here?
Yes. Rabbi alimni ma huwa khayrum indak.
Very good. And can you do the translation for me?
Oh my Lord, teach me what's best for me in your knowledge.
Jazakallah. Well done. Okay. So what we're today going to do is a revision lesson again. And the revision lesson is actually Idgham Naqis. And you've covered this before. Just give me a second. You make... Okay, so it's Idgham Naqis, and hopefully you remember, but I'll do a quick reminder. If a ya or a meem mushaddad, so if a ya or meem mushaddad appears after a noon sakin or a tanween, assimilation means idgham, will take place. And that idgham sound should be created. It is a nasal sound which should be 2 seconds long. And if the ya or meem mushaddad appears after a tanween, then only one tanween stroke will be used when doing idgham. So, for example, here we can see. Okay, just a quick reminder, those people who have, entered with their own names or a different name, can they please log out and then log in back again? You will be put into the waiting room. So I'm looking through the list now, and there are a few people who have entered with their own names or a different name. You will be removed right now. So if you could please enter with your correct ID, Jazakallah. Okay. So, for example, here we've got a noon sakin, and it says if there is a ya mushaddad, so it says if there's a ya or meem mushaddad. In this case, in red, you can see there's a ya mushaddad. And we can see before that there is a noon sakin. So it says here, if there is a noon sakin before the ya mushaddad, then idgham will take place. That means when you join this noon sakin with this ya, there will be a 2 second nasal sound will be created. So the correct way of saying this would be min yawmin. And same thing goes here. There's a ra mushaddad, and we've been told here if there is a noon sakin or a tanween, and in this case there is a tanween letter. The ya has a fatatain. So because there is a fatatain, when joining this with the vowel, we've been told that only one stroke of tanween will be used. So that means only one stroke will be used. And a nasal sound will be created. So, wali yawala. Okay, that was a quick recap of the lesson. So let's move on to here. Let's have a little bit of practice. So let me choose a student to help me. Let's see. Okay, can I have
1130?
Okay, can we have A1134? A1134, Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam, how are you?
I'm fine.
Good. So the rule that we quickly revised in just now, do you remember the name of that? Do you remember the name of this rule that I just told you just now?
Madhu.
Okay, no. It's Idrami Nakis, okay? Here, okay? Yeah?
Okay.
Good. Okay, so so if you remember, I just said that when you join a tanween letter to a vowel mushaddad or ya mushaddad, then a certain type of voice is created. Do you know what type? So I'll give you a clue. There is a nasal sound. Nasal sound is created. Do you know how long that nasal sound is?
Two.
Two. Very good. Well done. Do you want to help me with this first box here?
Famous dog.
Okay, right. Okay, so say that once more for me, please.
But must dog go on.
Okay, let me help you with this. So, what we idgham naqis means when you join this ra and the va, a nasal sound is created. Okay, so the correct way of saying this is fa mustaqar rungwa. Can you hear the rungwa? You can hear a slight nasal sound. Yeah.
Okay.
Do you want to have another go at saying this?
Fa mustaqarrwa.
Very good. Well done. Do you want to have a go at this one?
Rad bilwala.
Yeah. Do you want to have another go at this? Say this one more for me.
Rad bilwala.
Okay, good. Do you remember this tha? What type of tha is this? There's a rule that is applied here.
Fix sound.
Okay, I'll remind you. There are, so you've, I think last week or the week before, you've been taught a rule. Very good. Well done. So, exactly. So try saying this again, making sure that you do galgala on this thought.
Rod.
Okay. So when you do galgala, the correct way of doing that is you give it a little jerk. So it should be rota.
Rota.
Yeah. So do you want to have a go again at saying this whole word?
Rata. Rato.
Yeah. Very good. Just the only thing that you have to make sure that you bear in mind is when you join this ba with the va, a nasal sound should be created. So it should be rata binwa. Can you hear the binwa one? I'm doing this, I'm making this sound for 2 seconds, and you can hear a slight noon sound. Yeah, it's a hidden noon sound if you like. Rata binwa la.
Rata binwa la.
Very good, well done. Do you want to have a go at this one?
She,
yeah, so say that once more for me.
She,
okay, so remember what I just said before, that, do you know what rule is being applied over here where I've highlighted?
Nasal sound
should be created, yes. Idgham is taking place, okay? So, you're right in saying that a nasal sound should be created here. So, the correct way of doing that is Shia Aungwa.
Shia Aungwa.
Very good, well done. Do you want to have a go at this piece?
No.
Yeah, so naba imustaqarun
naba bum imus.
Very good, Jazakallah. Thank you for your help. L105, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can.
So is it okay if you help me select the students for me?
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah. I just wanted to check. So you've had A1134. Who was the student before that?
I had A1115.
Okay, that's fine.
Okay, and also just someone was entering with their own name, I think. I did put them in the waiting room, but they're entering with their own name again. So,
okay.
If you can have a look. And can I please have another student for the next line, please?
Yep, sure. So let's have A1120.
A1120, assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
How are you?
I'm good, thank you. How are you?
I'm good, alhamdulillah, Jazakallah. Thank you for asking. Do you want to have a go at this box for me?
Okay. Bavadatu ya laytani.
Okay, that's fine. Do you remember what rule we're looking at here? So this red and blue coloured letters, a rule is taking place here. Do you remember what the name is of that rule?
No.
No? It's idgham, so remember here we looked at idgham naqis?
Yes.
Okay, so that's the rule that we're paying particular attention to today. So, this rule, basically, if a ya or vowel mushaddad appears before a noon sakin or tanween, so in this case, the ta is a tanween ta, right? It has a dhammatain on top of it, yeah? So when you join this ta with this ya, a nasal sound should be produced for 2 seconds. So the correct way of saying this then is mawaddatun ya laytani. Yeah? Do you want to have a go at this now?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Can you hear that when you joined the sta with the ya, a slight nasal sound, like a noon type of sound was produced?
Yes.
It wasn't exactly a noon, but it was a nasal sound. So dunya.
Dunya.
Yeah? So that's what idghaminakis is, and that's taking place over here, okay?
Yes.
So can you try this here again? In these colored letters, the same rule is taking place. So keep that in mind and have a go at this one. Yeah, say that once more for me. Okay. After this dal, there is an alif. Do you know what type of alif this is?
No.
This is alif mad, okay? Yeah, so that means that the dal sound should be made long for 2 seconds, okay? And this is a noon, it's not a z, it's not a za, it's a noon, okay?
Okay.
So do you want to have another go at this? Yeah, just remember when you join the sta and the vowel, the sound, the nasal sound, how long should it be created for? How long should that sound be?
Two seconds.
Yeah, exactly. Well done. So it should be dumwa.
Dumwa.
Good, well done. Do you want to get this one for me? This box? Okay. Say this highlighted part for me. Okay, so over here what's happening is this is a yalin, okay? This is a yalin. So the correct way of saying this, and you know what would be helpful if you listen back to a few lessons where we covered this entire lesson about yalin. So the correct way of saying this is shay.
Shay.
Yeah. So if the ya is blank or has the skoon sound on top of it and the letter before has a fatha, which it does, then this ya becomes a yalin. That means that you say shay. Okay. That's how it would be produced, the sound. Okay. So shaytanam marida.
Shaytanam marida.
Very good. And you want to have a go at this last box?
Shay-iwa.
Yeah. Just again, how long should this sound be here?
2 seconds.
2 seconds. So try that again, making sure that this, when you join this hamza and waw, that the sound is for up to 2 seconds.
Shay-iwa.
So when I say it should be 2 seconds long, the vowel shouldn't be long, it's just that joining. So inwa, can you hear when I join, it's just that joining, when I join this hamza and the vowel, that sound, that joining sound should be 2 seconds long. Inwa.
Inwa.
Yeah, that's the correct way, okay? Well then, jazakallah for your help. Can I please have another student for the next line?
Yeah, sure. N1230.
Assalamualaikum.
Waalaikum salam. How are you?
I'm right, thank you.
Okay. Can you help me with this box over here? Okay, that was good, except for when, so do you remember this the highlighted letters? So I've made a little square around it. So when you join this star, okay, because the vowel has this W-like sign, do you know what that is called?
Shadda,
very good. So that means when when there is a shadda letter, you have to join it obviously with the letter before it, okay? So in this case, it's a da, right? So, but we've been told if there is a vowel mushaddad and a tanween letter before it, then, sorry? Yeah, it should be single, very good. And, but when you join it, a nasal sound is created, yeah?
Yeah.
So that means you should hear not a proper noon sound, but a slight hidden kind of noon sound. So when you join this da and the vowel, you should hear a slight noon kind of like a nasal sound.
Yeah.
For about 2 seconds. So that nasal sound, I'll do it for you, so maybe you understand more. So it should be dengwa. Can you hear dengwa?
Yeah.
Can you hear the n sound? That's what a nasal sound is, okay? Dengwa.
Mu'mina timvadiya.
Dengwadiya.
Timvadiyatun.
Very good, well done. Do you want to have a go at this one?
Da-i-ri-ya.
Okay, so this ya, how long should this ya be?
2 second nasal sound.
That's when you join it. But so let's forget what's before the ya, just the ya on its own. It's the, so forget about the tashdeed for a minute. What sign does it have on top of the mushaddad sign? A fatha. And how long is a fatha sound?
1 second.
1 second. So can you make sure when you can you make sure that the ya is only 1 second long?
Okay. Da-i-ri-ya. Ti-ru.
Say that once more for me. Just give me 1 second. Say ta-i-ri-ya ti-r.
Ta-i-ri-ya ti-r.
Good. Do you want to have a go at this box?
Vala'amatum mu'minatun.
Okay, say that once more for me and make sure that you focus on the rule over here.
Okay. Vala.
Okay, again, the noon here, what does the noon have on top of it?
Fata.
And how long should that sound be?
1 second.
Very good. So have another go. Make sure that the noon sound isn't prolonged. So good. Let me say it and repeat after me then. Wala amatum mu'minatun. Do you want to have another go?
Okay. Vala amatun mu'minatun.
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 Very good. Do you see how the noon sound was only 1 second now?
Yeah.
Very good. Well done. Do you want to have a go at this last box here?
Ayuki
Say that once more for me.
Ayuki-ah.
Okay, can you remember what rule is taking place over here?
Ishidda.
Yes, but the ya has a shada, but when you join this noon and the ya, what rule is taking place? Very good. So what type of sound should we produce?
Join the lift to the ya.
Yeah, but a nasal sound should be produced, okay? Ayu.
Ayu.
Yeah. Good.
Ayuki.
Good. Can I please have another student for the last line, please?
Yep.
Auntie.
Do, yes?
On Monday and Tuesday, the classes weren't working.
Yeah, I know. We had a little bit of a problem, but it's sorted out now. So apologies for that.
Okay.
Okay, so the next student is N1207.
Asalaamu Alaikum.
Walaikum Asalaam. How are you?
I'm fine, Alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah. Can you help me with this box over here? This last book. Good. Okay. Say this once more for me. Okay. Again, because remember the rule that we are covering is idgham naqis, okay? So, and the rule is that if there is a ya mushaddad, if that appears after a nun sakin or a tanween, but in this case there is a nun sakin, then when you join this nun sakin with this ya mushaddad, a nasal sound for 2 seconds will be produced, okay? So that is lanyaj. Yeah? Allahu.
Allahu.
Very good. Do you want to have a go at this one? Very good, very good. Your nasal sound here was very good. Well done. Your idgham was excellent. Do you want to have a go at this one? Very good. Just again, a little more focus here on the idgham. Maya. Kha needs to be prolonged because there is a alif mad after the kha. So it should be Maya kha fuhu. Good. And this last one here? Yeah, just say that once more for me. Very good. Jazakallah.
Jazakallah.
Okay, and that's it for the revision slides. Shall I hand it over to the examiner?
Yeah, that's fine. Is it okay if I share my screen?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, that's fine. Okay, assalamu alaikum, everybody. I'm just going to do a bit of an exam just to see how well you're doing with your recitation. So we are working from Surah Al-Baqarah because I've been told this is what you're sort of used to at the moment. So we're going to continue where your last teacher left off yesterday. So we're going to start with verse 46 of Surah Al-Baqarah. And if the day teacher is happy, you can go ahead and select any of the students that you want to have reciting today.
Yeah. Can I have... N1208.
Assalamualaikum. Waalaikum assalam. How are you?
I'm fine, alhamdulillah. How are you?
I'm good too, alhamdulillah. So can you see the screen clearly? Is everything visible?
Yes.
Okay, brilliant. So where you see this yellow dot, can you please start reciting from the beginning of verse 46, starting with A'udhu Billah?
A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitanir Rajeem. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim.
You can continue to the next verse.
الذين يظنون أنهم ملاقو ربهم وأنهم إليه راجعون.
Okay, Jazakallah. That was really well read. And one of my favorite points was that you read the Ayn especially well. So well done. In all of the places that you had the Ayn, you really tried from your throat. So really well done on that. There are just a few points that I highlighted. So this one over here first, it's just when you're joining this Ba with Kasra, with this Saad, just put a little bit more emphasis on it because it's a Shadda letter. It's got the Tashdeed above it. Just put a little bit more stress. So, Bis Sabri. Okay? Hold the sound a little bit longer. Can you read that word for me again?
Bis Sabri.
Bis Sabri.
Bis Sabri.
Okay, brilliant. And then one point over here was because we have the Ta Marbuta and you made a pause over here, when you're pausing on this word, it's going to become a Ha sound. So you're going to read it as Wassalah. Okay? So not the Ta sound from the Ta Marbuta, but Ha. Wassalah. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Okay, brilliant. Over here, the reason I highlighted over here on this ya is because I think you read the stroke incorrectly. So remember, it's really important that we don't change any of the strokes in the Holy Quran because it can have an impact on the meaning. So just be mindful of that. So I think you may have read it as a dhamma by accident, but just be careful of that. And the only other point that I highlighted was again on this meem mushaddad here, just put a little bit more stress on it again. So generally that was really well recited, really good effort, so well done and excellent on the Ayn especially. Yep. Did you have a question?
No, not really, but you know at the end of the class when the class is finished, is you know the Nazm competition, can I join?
I think you have to send, if the day teacher can correct me if I'm wrong, I think you're supposed to send in a recording of your Nazm to the email address. Can you just confirm that, day teacher?
Yes, that's correct. I can double check what the email address is, but just send the recording to info@nqc.org.uk.
So it's that usual email that you use if you want to communicate anything, info@nqc.org.uk. But I think maybe if you can have like another reminder at the end of the lesson.
Yeah.
Okay. Apart from that, did you have any other questions regarding any of the points that I highlighted?
No.
No, so you understand. Your main point for improvement is just where you're finding these letters which carry tashdeed, when you're joining the letters together, just put extra stress on those letters, okay?
Okay.
Okay, Jazakallah. Thank you very much. Shall we have a student from Adfal next?
Yeah. If I can have... A-1111.
Yeah, that's one. Aslan Agum. A-1111.
Assalamualaikum.
So could you please start reciting from here, from Ya Bani up until, if you can do it up to here first of all.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Ya Bani Israel ila Daskuru Ruuni Matiya Yaldati Antu Alaykum Wa Anni Fassaltukum Alal Alameen.
And if you can continue up to here, please.
No, so on the sea sin on the sin shay of the lay Balu min khashafa atan atubba la yo khadu min khad lubba lahum yansarun.
Okay, Jazakallah. So the first point I wanted to make at the start over here, what stroke can you see above the ya?
Vertical fatha.
Excellent. So how many seconds do we prolong that?
2 seconds.
Yeah, brilliant. So I just felt in the beginning it was a little bit too short. So remember, we want it to be at least 2 seconds, and then this one over here a little bit longer as well. So yeah, Benny. Okay, just a little bit longer on the ya. The other point over here was I think you read this as a sod. So this is a vod. So just pay attention because it's got the little dot on top. Fadhaltukum. Okay, I think you read it as fassaltukum. So again, it can sometimes have an impact on the meaning, which is why it's really important to recite it as it's written, okay?
Okay.
Okay, so the other points that I highlighted are... generally, it's a good recitation. I can see that you're trying really hard to join the letters correctly. There's just some places. So where you can see the shadda on the da over here, when you're joining this noon sakin with this noon mushaddad, when you're joining these two letters together, and also basically the places where you can see the following letter has a shadda on it, that's where there needs to be a little bit more stress. Do you understand what I mean? So over here, just read this word again for me. So this is qaf, okay? So this letter over here is qaf in the middle.
Wattaqu.
Excellent. So wattaqu. Put a bit more stress. Yeah, very good. Over here, because we're joining with a noon mushaddad, remember that you have to produce that nasal sound as well and put extra stress because of the tashdeed on the noon. An nafsin.
An nafsin.
Very good. And over here, and over here, and also over here, in all of these places, your day teacher was recapping on that type of idgham, where you have to produce a slight nasal sound and also pause for 2 seconds at least. So when you're joining this together, shay'anwa. Can you read that for me?
Shay'anwa.
Excellent, really good. Atunwa.
Atunwa.
Shafa'atunwa.
Shafa'atunwa.
Very good. Adilunwa.
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 Excellent. So that was the main point. Otherwise, really good effort. And I can see that you're trying to be as fluent as possible in your recitation, which inshallah will come with lots of practice. But otherwise, aside from the points that I mentioned, well done. Just pay attention to the lesson in particular that you were recapping today on idgham. Just remember those two things you have to look out for. So nasal sound and also pausing for 2 seconds, okay?
Okay,
jazakallah. And if we can have another student from Nasirat, please.
Let's see, can we have N1229?
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam, how are you?
I'm fine, alhamdulillah, how are you?
I'm good too, alhamdulillah. So could you please start reciting from over here, from the beginning of verse number 50?
Wa iz najjaynakum min aali fir'auna yasumunakum su'al azabi yuzabbihuna abna'akum wa yastahyuna nisa'akum wa fi zalikum bala'um min umir rabbikum azim.
Okay, jazakallah. That was really, really well read. Really good fluency. So excellent recitation, mashallah. The point that I wanted to just highlight here is just again, because you're joining this tanween sound, so you're not going to hear the tanween sound, but when you're joining it with a meem mushaddad, just to put that extra stress on it. Bala ummin.
Bala ummin.
Excellent. And then you picked up over here as well that when you're joining this noon sakin to this ra mushaddad, again, you're not hearing the noon sound. So can you read this and this part again, please?
Bala ummir rabbikum.
Bala ummir rabbikum.
Bala ummir rabbikum.
Excellent. Very well done. Aside from that was really well read. I just highlighted this letter Ayn and this letter Ha just because I think your recitation is really, really good. But to make it even better, when you come across these letters which are pronounced from the throat, just try and make the sound of the Ayn. So, Su al-Azabi. So you want to make the Ayn sound a little bit different to the Alif sound. So can you just read this again? Su al-Azabi.
Al-Azabi.
Excellent. So you're making a difference between the Hamza and the Ayn. And over here, so this Ha from your throat is going to be different from, let's see if I can see another example. For example, this Ha is a very simple Wala Hum. Whereas this Ha over here, Wayastahyuna. Wayastahyuna. So from your throat, if you can try that word for me.
Wayastahyuna.
Very good. So very well read. Really impressed, mashallah. Just keep working on the sounding of your letters, okay? Okay, jazakallah. Thank you very much. And if we have another tifl, please. Yeah.
If we can have A1134.
Yep. Assalamu alaikum. A1134. Assalamu alaikum. A1134. Can you hear me? Don't think he's there. So we can take someone else otherwise. Assalamualaikum. I think if we the sound's not very good, so let me just see if I can mute him and then unmute him again. No, it seems to have frozen, I think. Can we try a different student?
A1118.
Yep, that's fine.
Oh, sorry, then it just moved, jumped on me. Okay, so.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam. Are you A1118?
Yes.
Okay, brilliant. So we'll try A1134 later on, hopefully, if we have time. But if you can please start reading from here.
What is...
Starting with A'udhu Billah first, please.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. What is Falak Nabikumul Bahra Fa'an Khai Jai Na Kum Wa Agra Agrak Na Ala Fil Ha Ha O Na Wa An Tum tan ta tun. Wa is wa ad na ma mu sa al ba I na lai I a tan. Tuma mata kan tumu I ek la min bahdi hi wa an tum
Jazakallah, thank you very much. So there are a few points that I highlighted. The first one over here, do you remember what kind of ya this is that's joined to the jim? Do you remember what you call it? It's okay if you don't. Do you know what you do when you come across this? How long do you prolong it for?
1 second.
Not 1 second. So this over here is a ya lean, and we read it for 2 seconds. Okay. So the reason I highlighted it was just because I wanted you to make it a little bit longer. So for anjaynakum. Okay. So jaynakum. So this j and this na, they should be the equal amount of time, both 2 seconds, okay?
Okay.
Okay. And over here, I highlighted this qaf because remember, this is one of your qalqala letters. So what do you do on this qaf over here? How would you read this? What do you have to remember to do on this qaf, Sakin?
Prolong it.
So you don't prolong it, but you have to vibrate the sound a little bit, yeah? So you read it as aghraqna. So the way that you were reading it was just aghraqna, but you want the vibration on the qaf, raqna. Can you hear the difference?
Yeah.
Okay, so aghraqna. Try to read that word again, please.
Aghraqna.
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 Very good. And over here, again, we've got another example of a waw lean. So remember, when you have the two lean letters, ya and waw sakin, you're going to make the sound very soft and rounded. So fir'auna. Can you read that for me?
Fir'auna.
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 Excellent. Very good. And read this word again for me, please.
Tandurun.
Tanurun.
Tanurun.
So this letter za, just read it one more time, this word.
Tanurun.
Excellent, very good. So over here, arba'ina, I think it was a little bit too long. So how many seconds do we do it when we have just a fatha stroke on a letter?
1 second.
1 second, excellent. So read this word one more time.
Arba'ina.
Excellent, very good. So just be mindful of your timing. I think it was a little bit too long. Also over here, so what's this letter in the middle of this word?
Lam.
Lam, excellent. So I think when you're reciting, you read it as an alif by accident. So remember, alif, it's not going to be joined to anything if it appears in the middle of a word, yeah? So always remember that it's only lam that will be joined with the letters. So laylatan, read that for me.
Layla.
Laylatan.
Laylatan.
Excellent, very good. Over here, so what do we have on this meme?
Shadda.
Excellent. And what do you have to remember to do when you have a shadda on a letter?
You need to push on it.
So you need to put extra stress on it. But also, what does this letter have afterwards?
Shadda.
Yeah, so you have to remember to put double emphasis on both this meme and also this ta. So, thummat takhadh.
Thummat.
Thummat takhadh.
Thummat takhadh.
Mat takhadh.
Mat takhadh.
Very good. And over here, I think you read the jim accidentally as a kha. So remember that the kha has the dot on the top. So just read this word for me.
La.
You can join it with this one in the beginning. So.
Tumul
ijla.
Tumul ijla.
Yeah, so this alif over here, we're not pronouncing it. We're joining this mim with dhamma with this lam sakin. Tumul ijla.
Tumul ijla.
Very good. And just read this final word again over here, please.
Zalim.
Excellent, very good. So really good attempt. Just be mindful of the points that I highlighted. So especially look out for your lean letters and remember that they're quite a soft and rounded sound. So فَأَنْجَيْنَاكُمْ فِرْعَوْنَ لَيْلَةً. So that's one point. And just the second point was with your shadda letters, especially when you have two shadda letters together, remember to emphasize not just the first one, but both of them, okay?
Okay.
Okay, Jazakallah. Thank you very much. There's only a couple of minutes left, so I'm happy to hand it back to the day teacher if you want to make your announcements.
Yeah, okay.
So do you want, if you start sharing your screen.
Yeah. So before we finish off the class with the ending prayer, I just wanted to let everyone know if anyone is interested in singing Quran Sabse Acha, the Nazm Quran Sabse Acha, as part of the final class, which is on Friday, please send a recording of that to the usual email address, which is info@nqc.org.uk. So that is info@nqc.org.uk. And when you send your application, just write G1 Nazm application in the subject box. Apart from that, the homework for today is just to revise the verses that were covered today by the examiner. A good way of revision is to use your mobile phones and to record yourself and then listen back to yourself and then correct yourself. That's the best way of finding out where you're making mistakes. If you have a brother or sister that is also in the class, maybe listening to each other is a good idea as well, because then you'll pick up each other's mistakes. With the exam, as the examiner did tell you, you did really well. But fluency, inshallah, will come with time and with more practice. Practice makes perfect, so don't panic. Don't rush. Inshallah, fluency will come with more practice. And that's that. So if I can have a student to just help me with this and finishing prayer, please.
Yeah. Let's have N1226.
Assalamu alaikum, N1226.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam. How are you?
I'm fine, alhamdulillah. How are you?
I'm good, alhamdulillah. Jazakallah for asking. Can you help me with this finishing prayer? Can you come closer to the mic? I can't hear you.
Allahumma arhamni bil Quranil Azim.
Well done. And can you please do the translation?
Oh Allah, have mercy on me through the great Quran.
Jazakallah. Jazakallah, everyone.